Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to first look on Moe Ninja Girls RPG Shinobi. It's a gacha RPG developed and published by Entity Solmare, released on May 19, 2020. So it's a gacha RPG where you need to collect the outfit for your waifu. So it's not like normal gacha RPG where you collect the unit. So it's collect the outfit. But if you guys don't know, this game is originally from a visual novel game called Moe Ninja Girls, and I think it's available on Steam if you guys want to check it out. But of course, they changed the game to the mobile version, so it's not a visual novel because it's a gacha RPG where you need to collect the outfit. But the story is like any other harem anime where you have the main character and you have a lot of girls, and there are 15 girls in this game. And let's talk about the game. Right now, I'm at the main screen, and first of all, I really like the interface, the UI, in terms of looks. I think it looks very stylish and really cute, in my opinion. I really like it, but it's a little bit overwhelming, but not as overwhelming as like Chinese game, because Chinese game interface is really bad. But let's talk about the bottom feature, the character first. So they have the communication and memory. So the communication is like the power up, but so basically in this game, the character or the unit, you have bone XP and the outfit XP, and you can level them up. So if you tap the present, you can give them present and they get XP basically, and you can change character in the change clothes. It's not like changing clothes, it's just change character. And memories is like you can deepen the bonds for each character. So they have 15 characters or 15 waifu, and you don't really need to collect them all because you already have them right from the start. What you need to collect is the outfit, because the outfit have different stats, different rank. And this is the formation. So in this game, you can have three main character for each battle, and the other three is sub, and one of them is from the friend or random. But one thing that unique about this game is the outfit. So the outfit have an HP. So if you look at the character art, there is a bar that is the outfit HP basically. If it's lower, like this girl, it will lower your HP by half. Like this is the half, because it's already lost all their HP. But like I said earlier, they have the bone XP and the outfit XP or level, and you can upgrade or give them equipment, three equipment, and you can upgrade them, and they have limit break and skill at the right, ability and status. But not really like a lot of customization, but it's pretty basic customization. And then these are the crit, so you can crit the outfit like this. You can crit the outfit or the equipment, but you need some material. So this like the gacha for the outfit basically. But when you crit, you need the material and time basically. So there is a time. So you cannot like pay money like straight up. So there's a limit of how many times you can do it. And then these are the equipment. You can upgrade stuff. So you guys can see you can upgrade stuff, outfit, skill and stuff. And these are the men. So earlier I said the outfit have HP. So this is the feature that lets you fill the HP for your outfit, so your outfit HP will full again. And let's talk about the gameplay and jump to the main story. And I can show you the gameplay, but I really like the art and the look of the game. I think it's really slick and really good art. So let's talk about the quest. And because this is from visual novel, the story is like slideshow, but it's really good story. So they have main quest, the party dress base is even, and daily quest. So it's not a lot of game modes so far, but I'm still in the season 1. So let's go to the season 1. So let's go here and, oh my god. So they have main story and side quest. Main quest and side quest basically. So these are the main quest. So this is I think only story chapter, but I'm gonna show it a little bit the story. So it's like any other visual novel, it's like slideshow but no voice acting. But the story I think is really good because I read the first few chapter, I think the story is pretty good because it's from visual novel, so the write for the stories I think is pretty good. But let's just skip it because I want to show you the gameplay. And we got an item like normal. But the look of this game is like it's just good. It's really good. So these are the battle and for each chapter you have like the side quest. So these are the battle, so let's just do it. Maybe we can do manual. And like any other game, you need to bring like random or the friend or friend. We still lower power though, but okay, let's just do it. It's because my character is the outfit is red, and it's really annoying because you need some material to fix the outfit, and it's really annoying because the material is take so long. So these are the battle. It's turn based. Oh my god, it's one shot my character. What the fuck? Oh my god. So these are the battle. So at the top left is your character, your own character. So you can have a skill like this. Let's just use this to activate. And then your character have two bar. If you look at it, the top is HP and the bottom is your turn bar. If it's full, it's your turn. And they can have normal attack or skill like this skill. And they also have limit break, but you need to charge them first like normal. And that's it probably because there is not much other than that. I think the unique thing is probably the character skill because you can have Kamui, just like the ultimate I think. But it's like a buff for your character, so it's not really like, you know, like skill. It's just buff for your character on the battle. But it's still unique feature I think for the gameplay. But I think the enemy is pretty strong. I think my character is pretty low level because it's very hard to level up this game. I think because I'm still low level, I think, but the gameplay is pretty basic. It's just turn-based. I think they can work on the animation a little bit because the animation is a little bit bland. It's a little bit, I don't know. It's okay, I think. So we got an item. As you guys can see, some of my character, the outfit is kinda break. Like that. Slash a little bit. So you can repair the outfit. But you need material and the material is very hard to get. I just do more. Oh yeah, before I forgot, the character have element at the top right, as you guys can see, like 5 element, and every character or every outfit have different job or class basically. Like as you guys can see, there is the element and job. So So that's a little bit not different, but makes the gameplay a little bit complex, a little bit at least. But the actual gameplay is pretty basic, turn-based, not really special other than the your character buff. Just auto. Just always get one shot. I think the outfit is pretty important in this one, because if your outfit at zero, it will get one shot like that. Like, it's so stupid. Like, you need. Oh my god, I think we are gonna lose, because the outfit is really important, this one. You need to have full HP at the outfit. But maybe my character is just low level, I don't know. But the animation, I think they can work on. Other than that, I think it's pretty decent gacha game. But it's not really my style of gacha, because I prefer normal gacha game. Like normal gacha grindy game. But this kind of game is like waifu collector. Like maybe Kantai Collection or Azur Lane, those kind of waifu collector game. Which is fine, I'm not hating it, but it's just not my style, I think. Maybe we can do the daily quest so I can show you the other game modes. But so far it's pretty fun early experience in my opinion. I don't really have a lot of complaint other than maybe the game is a little bit confusing because the feature in this game is a little bit different than normal game. Like the outfit is a little bit different, so it's maybe for some people it's a little bit confusing for them. But I don't mind, because I don't mind learning the game. But of course, not many people want to learn the game, you know. Sometimes people just want to play the game that they already knew, because maybe they have bad mood or something. But I don't mind learning the game. But the character is very cute though, the chibi art, I think it's really cute. Oh my god, it's always just one shot. We always get carry by friend character though. That's kinda sad. So these are the daily quests, but it's not really different than the main quest, it's just normal. Normal gameplay like any other turn-based game. She's really cute though, the main heroine, the pink girl. I think she's the main heroine. But of course, it's a visual novel, so you can choose whatever girl you want. So that is the one of the main quests. You can get different stuff. Maybe we can do other daily quests. For some reason, this screen reminds me of Doki Doki Literature Club. That's the Doki Doki game. I think it's on Steam. It reminds me like that. I think Doki Doki is pretty good visual novel game. Oh my god, that is a high level. I think we're gonna lose. There's no way we can win. It's gonna get one shot. So the daily quest is very hard, as you can see. It's not easy. It's gonna get one shot. Damn. The number is so much though. I don't like when a game, early game, have a lot of numbers. I don't like it. I think it's pretty annoying to see. Let's just do other content. I think I can show you the memories maybe. Let's go back. I never tried the memories, so I don't know how is it work. But it deepened the bonds for its waifu, I think. Or the character story. So these are the girls, and to be honest with you, I don't have one that I like. I think if I have to choose, probably this kind of girl is what I really like, this kind of hot babe. So let's just, so they have the two story, bone story and outfit, so let's just do bone. I mean, look at that, she's pretty hot though, come on. If I'm the main character, I'm gonna choose her, definitely. So these are the story. I don't know if there is a gameplay in there, but there's only story. But I think the story is pretty, like the one of the most positive or the best feature in this game, because it's from visual novel, so of course the story is pretty good compared to other gacha game. Is there any gameplay in this? I don't think so, because you cannot choose. So it's just story feature basically, I think. Maybe I'm wrong, let's see. It's just story. Maybe dev gameplay and, but that's it maybe, because I'm not really end game player, so I'm just play the game. But anyway, that's it for this game. So let's talk about the positive. The positive probably first is the graphic. The art is just really beautiful game in my opinion. And the story is really good. It makes the character feels alive because it's from this one novel. So the story is pretty deep. So that's good. And the interface or the UI, I really like it. It's pretty stylish and pretty cute. And maybe other than that, the game is different at least with the outfit. So it's unique a little bit. So that's positive. The negative set is probably the game modes. They don't have really a lot of game modes, as you guys can see. Only main story, daily quests, and those kind of story quests for each character. And that's it so far. Other than that, maybe the game is a little bit confusing at first because the feature is a little bit different from any other normal gacha game. So you need to learn the game, but not every people want to learn the game. So other than that, maybe that's it, because I think it's pretty good gacha game, but again, it's not my style of gacha game. I prefer normal grindy gacha game, but I think it's still pretty good. So if you guys like what you see, I'm gonna have a link down in the description for you guys check it out. I hope you guys enjoy the video, and I'll see you guys next one. Later!